Hey folks, Dave here. I am known on YouTube as the not-so-evil Evil Viking 13, and welcome to The Witcher 3 Blood and Wine. This is the final expansion pack for The Witcher 3, and it's supposed to be the end of the adventures of Geralt of Rivia. As a long-time Witcher fan who read the entire novel series after playing the first game, I'm not entirely sure that I'm ready for the end, but I do know that I am ready for a lot more adventuring. And this is supposed to be quite a long DLC. I've heard upwards of 30 to 40 hours. So, even if this is the end, we do have a lot ahead of us. Let me cut my UI back on here. I am heading down into town.
Let's go.
To check the notice boards for the quest that will begin our new adventure. Someone yell for help? This is being played, recorded, and rendered at 1440p and 60fps, as well as almost entirely ultra settings, so if your browser can support it, be sure to crank up that resolution for the maximum possible quality. Oh wow, it's actually addressed directly to us. Appeal to Sir Geralt of Rivia, the bridge his crest. At the behest of our merciful sovereign, Her Illustrious Grace Anna Henrietta, we have journeyed to the Northern Realms to lay before you our mission. A terrible monster has appeared in the Duchy of Toussaint, a beast that has committed heinous crimes against Her Grace's subjects. Only the most famous among Witchers has the ability to destroy the beast. Thus, we humbly beseech you to appear in the village of Holloway. Your humble servants. Oh wow, those are some intense names. Sir Palmerin de Lunful and Milton de Pyrac Pyron, knights in service of Her Grace and the Duchy. Hear our woes and liberate our land from the clutches of fear. Oh nice, a quick read button. That is definitely helpful. So now we need to travel to, I believe it was Holloway. Meet the knights from Toussaint in Holloway. Alright guys, I'm gonna go ahead and ride off, and we'll catch up here in a second.
This be the Witchman, the freak of nature.
I've been making my way through war-torn Velen, and we're almost up here to the settlement. I believe this is just outside of Oxenfurt. Yeah, you can actually see the bridge there in the distance. Oh, wow. Yeah, someone's got some fancy horses for sure.
I've not got no need for your help.
Have no fear, good man. Our labors shall be done quickly. The prowlers to be banished for good.
Milton, look.
Geralt.
In the flesh.
Hail, Witcher. Let us go inside and greet you as befits an old friend.
And you, fear not. We shall put an end to the rule of outlaws soon.
Those plumes.
Found your message on a notice board.
You see, Palmerin, I told you. The griffin at White Orchard. I knew that were we only to follow the tracks of its slayer, we would in the end find Geralt.
Milton de Peyrac Peyrin and Palmerin de Lanfor. Good to see you both. Been years.
Be assured, we share your joy.
You must forgive us our, surroundings. When we pledged to place the village under our protection, the village elder gave us this hut as our lodgings. He swore it is the best hut in the village.
Get involved in some squabble?
We discovered that in retreating, the Redanian garrison that left this land still is at the mercy of numerous plagues. The tyranny of bandits the most onerous among them. These plunderers shall soon descend on this village to collect tribute. Milton and I will dissuade them.
We are both sworn to fight injustice and oppression wherever they rear their heads. The matter does not concern you, of course, but do us the kindness of waiting. Once we have dealt with these marauders, we have a matter we must present to you.
I'm gonna help. I mean, bandits are bandits. Yeah, there's gonna be more, but evil is still evil.
So, plan to go out and meet the bandits when they arrive? Fight them?
Palmerin wishes first to appeal to their sense of decency. But I expect they will be deaf to this.
Yeah, completely.
We must afford them a chance to stand down. Many a hardened outlaw has left the path of wrongdoing upon hearing words of admonition.
Doesn't happen in these lands. Ever.
If they do not heed my reprimand, we at least will know we have done all within our means to evade bloodshed.
Fine. Naturally, I'll help when Palmerin's rhetoric falls on deaf ears.
Excellent. Then we've but to wait for the rogues to arrive.
They are coming!
Hear that? Your bandits have arrived.
Let us go out to greet them.
Quite the tribute they're trying to take here.
Hark! Contemptible curs!
He mean us?
Aye, Palmerin de Lanfor call upon you to repent. Search your hearts. Do you not see that they are blackened?
Regular punch and duty here.
To prey upon commoners is no honor. To loot their meager stores, abandon the path of shame, and we will spare you.
Right, good jest, that. Had us a laugh. Now, fuck off before we lose our patience and you lose something else.
Nay, wait, Zorg. These lads are a lark. Mayhaps they know some tricks.
Oi, players! Can you toss balls all loopity-like? Or do that thing where one spits fire while the other farts.
Noble Palmerin's given you a chance. Now I'm gonna give you some advice. Do what he says.
Or what?
Or you'll find yourself fighting knights errant in the pay of the Duchess of Toussaint. And they eat scum like you with their morning porridge.
Well, there's three of them. Two turtled up in armor. We'll come back later.
Some wench sent them. Folk who say we's afeard of wenches and jesters.
Ooh, insulted the Duchess. Not good.
Indeed, we cannot let the affront go unpunished. I swear upon the Heron you will pay with your own blood! By the crane, villains, ready your arms!
Oh wow, look at the map. This is a huge group. Go for the archers first. No mercy. One ground stab right there. No, you don't, Archer. There goes another one. Trying to knock his shield loose. No such luck so far. Oh, nice finisher. He's the leader. Oh, no you don't, buddy. Get some mushrooms going there. And there goes their leader. And another bandit down. Okay, Quinn. Get some health back. And what do you think you're doing?
Time to end this.
Both sides at once. Oh, just you left, friend? I'm gonna get him with Axie. If I can even get to him.
Pathetic.
And down he goes.
Why do they not emerge? It is over. We have banished the scoundrels, lifted oppression's yoke from their lives.
Warned you it'd be like this. Fear you as much as they did the bandits now. Sorry, no fanfares and flowers. You're not in Toussaint.
Ach, it is true what folk claim. In the north, no noble deed goes unthwarted. It is time to go home.
And we shall, my friend.
Come, Geralt. It's time we delivered our message.
So fess up. What brings you such a long way?
We are to deliver Her Grace the Duchess's message in full, with all due ceremony. For tradition...
is sacred in Toussaint. All right, fine.
Most honorable Geralt, slayer of monsters and all evils nefarious, which prey on the defenseless of this world. Whereas never have you been known to deny help to the innocent, nor leave widows and orphans to fates undeserved. Answer you now our present summons. Free us from the beast which floods our streets with blood, and sows panic in the hearts of rich and poor alike. Come to our aid, Witcher.
Thus humbly beseeches you the star-crossed city's most gracious protectress, Her Illustrious Highness, Duchess Anna Henrietta.
Shall you answer her call?
Anna Henrietta really say all that? Word for word?
Well, in point of fact, she said, bring me the Witcher and dare not spare your horses. Only make certain this time he comes alone. The Ducal Chamberlain added the rest. You know how it is.
Yeah, I remember.
I might add, be it unofficially, that a hefty reward awaits. Yet the specifics you will need to verify with Her Illustrious Highness.
It's also clear that Dandelion is not welcome back in Toussaint.
Might be the most fervent request that I take a contract ever, and the most polite. And now we've got all that behind us. I want to hear more about this beast. Some kind of monster? Just guessing.
Most assuredly, though no one has caught a good look at it as yet. Our only sure witnesses, bodies massacred in a brutal, horrid manner.
Look, some sketches drafted from descriptions given by those who claim they glimpsed the beast. Each quite different. To my mind, these witnesses lie.
How many victims so far?
Two. When Her Grace learnt of the second, she discharged us immediately to fetch you, promising grants of land and fortunes in gold, should you answer her summons.
An ill wind blows, Geralt. The beast cannot be tracked. Folks say it wields black magic. Also, both victims were nobly born, and the start of a tourney draws near.
Beast wields black magic? What makes you say so?
The first victim vanished between bites at a feast. Of the feast-goers, none noticed this. They saw but an open window, then heard desperate cries from the street below, where a corpse had just been found.
The second killing, similar. A knight in a locked room. Servants all about the house. Guards all around the estate. Yet the beast somehow got him out, dragged him to the town square, and killed him there. No one saw nor heard a thing.
We have no fear of creatures against which sword and shield protect, but of this beast, nothing is known. Save that it cannot be traced, kills effortlessly, and with no rhyme or reason we can discern.
Anyone tried to hunt it? Knights errant, for example?
Ha! Many have tried. Baiting, waiting in ambush, but to no avail.
The beast is clever. It evades all traps and attacks of a sudden. It is like a ghost.
An experienced tracker. This is what we need, with knowledge of monsters. In short, we need you.
Mentioned a tourney. Why doesn't the Duchess just call it off?
Simply, it is too late. The guests have arrived. The best knights of all lands, relatives of the Emperor. The beast could be a threat to others, not just to Her Grace's subjects.
Got it. Before an aristocrat dies, at best it's a scandal. At worst, a diplomatic incident. I sometimes think back to all the contracts I've ever taken from sovereigns. Can't name hardly any where I came out ahead.
You cannot be thinking to refuse.
No. Just struck by a thought. How the Duchess can sometimes be... demanding.
So you accept the contract? Excellent!
We must set off at once. We long wanted this land searching for you, yet time is of the essence.
Ready to go, soon as you're packed.
Ha! Then post haste to Toussaint.
To Toussaint!
And we are off to Toussaint. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm excited.
Toussaint, the land of love and wine.
Exactly how I remembered it.
You will find Beauclair has changed some these past years.
Walk about when you have the chance. You will see for yourself.
To me, place always seemed straight out of a fairy tale. Knights errant, elven palaces.
You insinuate that we are somehow odd? I shall prove you wrong. This I pledge on the Heron.
Well, that is quite the welcoming party. Just got real Dark Souls here, guys. Oh man, he hits hard. Look, I can spin too. Oh, not good. Corner. Oh, he's bleeding good now. Bleed out, bleed out. Yes, there he goes.
Big beast. Tackling it single-handed? None too wise.
Neither is Luff born of wisdom, Witcher. So, Guillaume, out with it. Which fair damsel inspired you to vow to kill that filth?
The most beautiful among them.
If he wishes to guard her name a secret, he need not reveal it.
You I do not know, sir, nor seem you a knight, yet still I am profoundly grateful, nay, indebted to you for your succor. This trophy, sir, is yours.
A giant this close to human settlements? Strange.
Well, that was no ordinary giant. His name was Goliath, rumored to have been a knight once, but one who broke his vows. For this, the Lady of the Lake transformed him into a wild giant and banished him into the Gorgon Hills.
So he came back down? Why?
Several times each year, hunger chased him into the lowlands. Goliath had killed and devoured many shepherds. Guillaume's hunt served a noble cause. At any rate, it's a tale for more agreeable environs.
I'll take the trophy. Why not? Could find someone who'll pay to buy it. Put up a good fight against the giant. Got experience battling monsters?
None. In Toussaint, we mostly chase bandits. But I vowed I'd bring my heart's champion the head of a monstrosity, as the famed Gottfried, known as the Giant Killer, did.
You don't mean to hunt the beast, I hope. The matter's best left to Geralt.
Another challenge awaits me. Yet if Geralt is to hunt the beast, he ought to know. It struck again.
The river surrendered a corpse. It washed up in the meander by the cockatrice. Damien Delatour's guardsmen are there already, securing the area.
Securing the area? Better go there now before they trample any tracks, manhandle any evidence.
Set forth, then. I shall ride for the city to inform her gracious magnificence that Geralt has arrived. We'll meet later, near Guillaume's tent at the Tourney grounds. I shall take you then to see her grace.
There's the classic knife flip. Geralt the CSI.
Brave kid, Guillaume.
Farmerin oversaw his upbringing. Guillaume is his kid.
Mutations and Grandmaster Witcher gear. Ooh, we're gonna get a messenger letter. Wow. This is just beautiful.
Can't get used to the way you knights talk. Especially how you switch back and forth between flowery and, well, near normal.
We are knights errant, in the service of her gracious magnificence. When we appear in her name or speak on her behalf, we are bound by tradition. Must have removed the body already.
Let's look around, make sure they didn't miss anything.
All right, let's take a look. A fish, unsurprising. Anything out here in the docks? Nothing actually. Just wow. This is a fairy tale land.
Hobnailed boots, multiple sets of prints. Ducal guard, clearly. Let's see where they went. Walked along the shoreline.
Perhaps the body lay on the bank.
I hear drowners. There's a lot of debris here, too.
For the glory of her grace,
got guests. Careful.
Oh. Skurver. Level 33, too.
I will fend you all.
Oh, okay. He explodes. I gotta get my coin shield up here. Thank you for the free health. Thankfully, my armor does actually very slowly regen my vitality. I've been staring at this level up for a while. Let's go ahead and pick what I'm going to use this point on. Yeah, I'll use it on an additional point to my strong attack. Nice. Yeah, what happened here?
Anything taken by the current ends up in these shallows.
Yes, the stench is fierce.
Got a platter. More footprints.
Only blood-soaked scraps left of the victim's clothing. Good quality cloth.
A wealthy victim, correct?
Looks it.
Lots of nets here.
Blood. Guardsmen pulled these nets out of the water, then cut the mutilated body free. Gonna dive in, make sure they didn't miss anything.
Use your Witcher senses to search the net for clues.
Nets were attached here. Look at the rut. Guardsmen left this site by boat recently, probably to transport the body somewhere.
Oh wow, a bunch of nets. Ducal guardsmen's boots. Broken ore. Got a fish. Ha, the center net. Angerdrift, monogrammed DLC.
Monogrammed DLC. A noble's accessory, clearly. Be nice to know where they took the corpse.
What now?
This isn't the site of the murder. We know that. Current brought the body here. Corpse got caught in the nets. Guardsmen pulled it out, put it in a boat and took it somewhere. Need to find out where. I'd like to look at the corpse before it starts to decompose.
The inn. Its patrons must have seen the guardsmen. Which direction they took. We should ask there.
They're all watching.
Seems we've got ourselves an audience.
You think this surprising? The locals will tell the children of children they do not have yet of the day a quartered corpse was pulled from the river.
One thing. Found a handkerchief in the water. Monogrammed DLC. Mean anything to you?
Delacroix? It cannot be. Was it he the beast slew?
Seems so. Knew him well?
Long past. We were close friends once, but our paths diverged. He was a man of extremes, standing by his companions no matter the odds, fighting his foes to the bitter end.
Foes? You have a lot of them?
He did, but I do not see what that has to do with the beast. Ah, Geralt, you've struck a raw nerve. Memories of a time long past, to which I'd rather not return now.
I understand. We can talk later. Let's go to the tavern.
I shall have to leave you soon. Return to court.
Barely got back to Toussaint.
A knight in the service of her illustrious highness knows no rest. In fact, I'd feared I would return too late to fulfill my duty. Yet it seems I've arrived in the nick of time.
Come on, Roach. Oh, we're not leaving yet. Awkward. I'm coming, Milton.
Once you have finished examining the corpse, be sure to report to Anarieta.
Anarieta?
Her Grace, the Duchess. I forget myself at times. We address each other by our first names in private. Never in Pomeran's presence, however. He finds such familiarity offensive. A watering hole for traders, smugglers, boatmen. But you will find no better crayfish chowder in all Toussaint.
They say Her Grace has called in someone to tend to the beast. Killer from the north, they say.
What? With no lads brave enough?
Of course we have, but bravery is not enough against the beast. He wields dark powers. That calls for a witcher.
By my troth! Could that be the musty scent of fresh pate?
Naught else, Sir de Peyrac Peyren. I see time has not dulled your senses.
We would be honored if you would join us. Your companion as well.
But why do I not detect even a whiff of crayfish chowder?
No soup today, on account of there being no crayfish. I reckon you've not heard, but all I caught was a corpse. I awoke at the crack of dawn, as I do each day. But when I looked up, I beheld a blood-red sky.
This corpse is precisely why we're here. For the man whom you've invited to join you at the table was summoned from a far-off land by Her Gracious Magnificence. He is tasked with tracking and killing the beast.
We invited two men to join us, yet since Sir de Peyrac Peyren in temperament is more akin to hare than hound, I surmise the other is the hunter. With whom do we have the pleasure?
Name's Geralt.
A humble introduction. You've clearly not tarried long with Sir de Peyrac Peyren.
Spare us the petty insults. Geralt is a master of the witchery trade. He has questions concerning the beast's last victim.
I was the one to find the corpse. The sun had just risen when I awoke, sat straight up in my bed, looked out the window, and beheld a sky red as blood.
Ask Geralt, please, or we shall be here till winter.
Must have been early in the morning. Went to check your nets and then...
I stepped out of my hut and saw...
By my troth, to the point, man. You found a body ensnared in your crayfish nets. We know this already. What happened then? Did you see anyone nearby? Did you spy anything noteworthy? Anything at all?
Not a soul around, just me. As for noteworthy... well...
What did you see? But be warned, if I hear the sky was red again...
I saw... a head. Bobbing, eyes bulging, the tongue blew and popped out. Next to it, a hand rocking upon the water.
Get a good look at the body parts?
They gave me such a fright, I bolted to town fast as my legs would take me, then returned with guardsmen who told me to keep out of their way. They had a hard haul. The parts were so tangled up in my nets, they were forced to cut them.
Well, that's not helpful.
Need to examine the body. Know where they took it?
They ferried it across, then loaded it on a cart and hauled it to a cellar at Corfo Bianco to keep it cool, see?
What? Why, Corfo Bianco is Baron Rossell's estate. When he learns they've turned his cellar into a morgue, he'll set his hounds on them.
While you were gallivanting about the north, his vineyard was auctioned off.
Who was that? Woman who just left. Didn't see her before. Didn't notice her walk in, either.
Doubtless Linus, the innkeep's daughter. But hold, Geralt, because this is an outrage. Rossell's vineyard was auctioned off? Inconceivable.
It is no secret the Baron had gambling debts up to his ears. It finally came time to collect. His creditors auctioned off his property. The Ducal Chancellery bought it, in fact. Russell now bunks with his brother in Vicar Faro.
I told Russell he'd get his comeuppance. How long can one draw on past heroics? His creditors must finally have defined that his promises meant nothing.
Such are the times. Today's knights are pale shadows of the heroes of yore.
It's true what they say. God sent the beast to punish us for straying from the old paths.
So folk think the beast's divine punishment.
Knights have turned their backs on the old customs. Where they were defenders of the duchy, they're now defenders of their own tushes.
Why, you insolent?
Let him talk.
The Duchess trades in titles, grants honors to ill doers. We've strayed from the path of virtue, lost the gods' favor, so the gods sent retribution.
Don't listen to that nonsense, Geralt. It's rehashed street preacher codswallop.
Yes, the rebel rousers have been sprouting up like weeds lately, each offering the same bill of goods.
They say anything else about the beast, besides it being a messenger of the gods?
The Toussaint are no fools. They see clearly the beast kills on days honoring patron saints.
Picky monster. Thanks for the hospitality. Time I examined the corpse.
Corvo Bianco lies a short way from here, near the tourney grounds. Just follow the road and you'll arrive.
Not coming with? Oh yeah. Duty of some sort calls.
Some sort? Her Grace bestowed a great honor on me, even before we departed for Velen. I'm to play the hare during this year's game in the palace gardens. When you see me in my costume, you will wet yourself laughing.
A little tempted to ask a few questions, but it sounds like a long, complicated story. One involving lengthy digressions into local history and tradition. So, see you later, Milton, and good luck.
Okay. Go to Corvo Bianco and examine the body kept in its cellar. First, I'm gonna see if that woman is still around. I don't see her anywhere. Well, that seems a bit dangerous. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and examine the body. I'll check the notice board here before we leave. Nobleman, out of the way. You're not going to use this. Caravan escort. The Great Gwent Tournament. Okay, that's officially the first contract I'm going to pull off the board.
Invitation to a Gwent tournament, due to take place at the Pheasantry, organized by a certain Count Monnier.
Now that sounds like fun. Let me grab that auction announcement too.
Ducal clerks looking for help. Could be good coin to be made.
Tell you what, guys, let's branch off of the main quest just briefly and go check out that Gwent tournament. That'll give us an excuse to ride into town just briefly. Roach, where are you? There you are. Oh man, I just want to go out here and explore the countryside. Look at all this.
Hey there.
You know what, guys? I'm gonna turn my UI off, and we're just gonna ride into the city. I can't resist. I've gotta check it out. Especially with Gwent at the end of that little trip.
Sounds of a fight. Have to hurry.
Oh. Actually.
Damn it. Killer must still be here.
A diversion.
In the cellar. Gotta be.
Looks like investigating the bodies, not gonna be able to wait here, guys. Oh.
Busted ribs, blood from the ears. Took a solid hit. Killed with a single blow.
Well, it hits hard, is about all we know.
River Muck carried the body in his cart. Footprints. Small, bare feet lead deeper into the cellar. Hurled against the wall with great force. Used this to batter down the grate.
The body?
Took a lot of strength to batter this down. Why'd you kill these people? Clearly wasn't for their blood. We don't have to fight.
I cannot let you leave.
Oh, Bruxa. Let's put a Yurden down. I feel like Quinn's probably a good idea too.
Yep.
Okay, time for a swallow. I think it's also time for a vampire oil, because she is putting up a pretty solid fight. I might just have the enhanced vampire oil. No, I have the basic. That's not good. Come on. Creepy laughter. Gotta get another Yurden down. Gotcha. That was a fight and a half. Vampire saliva.
Stinks. Waterlogged. Both hands amputated. Body was quartered, just as I thought. Laid in water for some time. Head swollen, and something took a few bites out of it. Something in the throat. A pouch, bulging with coins.
In the throat?
Nilfgaardian florins, from several different provinces. If the murderer did this, means we're dealing with a sentient thinking beast. Body was chopped up after death. Blows struck with great force, but bones sliced through, not crushed. Creature that killed him had long claws, sharp as a witcher's blade. First sank its claws into the victim's heart. No Bruxa did this. Third hand. A spare? Except it's clearly not the victim's. Guardsmen must have not noticed it as they picked everything up. How's this possible? Still warm. Blood still flowing. Several monster species can regenerate. Never heard of that happening to their severed limbs, though. Or of their limbs seeming completely alive after so much time.
What on earth?
Examine the tissue more closely later. Might learn something. So, murderer was clearly a monster, but not a Bruxa. But then why'd the Bruxa come here for the severed hand? And who does the hand belong to? Why the hell's it still warm? Now, pouch shoved down the victim's throat. What's the significance? And why was he chopped up into pieces? Lots of questions, no answers so far. Need to know about the other victims. I'll ask Pomeran to get me in to see the Duchess.
Okay, guys. That's going to probably have to be the end of this first episode. After that unexpected detour because of the, well, massacre here at the vineyard. I think time is of the essence here, so I'm going to put that Gwent tournament aside. And we're going to go ahead and check in with the Duchess as soon as we get to the city. I do love me some Gwent, but I don't think this can wait even for just a couple of games. I hope you guys are enjoying Blood and Wine so far. I definitely know that I am. As usual, CD Projekt Red has actually exceeded my ridiculous levels of hype. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you all next time.